press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
I never aspired to join MBA. I never wanted to go to a B school.
Oh, okay.
I was more in the technical side of things in India.
Absolutely.
There is no proper biotechnology career. So I was like, at one point I liked the course very much, but the only option for me was to go into research. So one spot actually, because our campus, as you said, it's one of the biggest campus of IIM system.
Oh, okay.
And our hostel is located down the hill and the academic block is up on the hill. So you have to literally climb 1,000 steps to go to the academic block.
So hi Krishna, welcome on to the Real Humans of B School. So how do you feel, Krishna, being out here?
Hey, hi Nisha, I'm really glad to be here actually. Because once you go into IIM, you want to share your experience with other people also. Because even we were in the same phase during last year.
Absolutely.
We were going for interviews. We didn't know what next. We didn't know whether we'll get selected or not and which B school to choose. So everyone will be in dilemma right now, this phase. So it will be really glad if I can help in any way.
Awesome. That's really good. So when you were preparing, did you ever think that I'm going to be going online and giving everybody else advice and tips in future?
No way, actually. My story of how I ended up in IIM Indore is totally different, actually. It was totally lucky story. Because
okay.
I never aspired to join MBA. I never wanted to go to a B school.
Oh, okay.
I was more in the technical side of things. I just wrote CAT because I prepared for GRE and somehow I got a good score and got interview calls. I thought, why not interview, because IIM is a prestigious institute, why not give interviews? And luckily, after giving interview, I didn't expect anything. I was like, it's fun, it was fun. At least we had some experience. But one day in May month last year, I think that's May 3, May 3rd of May, I got a mail from IIM Indore, I have been selected for admission. I was
so
happy actually.
So completely out of luck, you were saying. So you were focusing on giving GRE instead of CAT earlier?
Actually, I didn't have any specific goal in mind because after we joined engineering, in last 2 years, the third year or fourth year, we usually get nervous. We won't know what to do.
Correct.
So I thought, like, I was also so nervous because I didn't have a very good profile or very good CGPA. And I didn't have any goal in mind. So I thought I was very scared and I gave everything I got. I wrote GRE, GATE, CAT and CAT for placements also.
Wow.
So I just tried everything and luckily everything went well.
Wow, that's so nice and that's so good of you to be honest. You know, actually when I'm an engineer and everybody in the last 2 years is like so clueless ki pata nahi kya karna hai, placements mein baithna hai, which exams to give, how to go about and all of them. So you mentioned your CGPA was not great. So what was your CGPA?
I was a 7-pointer. I was during the time of interview, I had 7.7.
Okay.
And during the time of admission, I got 7.99. It's still not 8, it's 7.99.
Okay. All right. 7.99. Not bad. But yes, I think at VIT, everybody gets an 8 and a 9 these days. I mean, you know, it's really very, very competitive. So you come from a biotechnology background, right? So how was that change for you from biotechnology to coming to management now?
Yeah, I was actually from computer science group in 11th and 12th. So
okay.
The way I choose biotechnology is also a bit of interest, I can say, because during 11th and 12th, when I was looking for courses, I felt that biotechnology is a different course and it was quite interesting also. So I chose the course and it was in VIT, it was not in any NIT. I got seat in NIT also, but I thought it was in VIT and it's a good course. I chose that.
Interesting.
And after going there, I found the course very interesting also. Though I didn't score much CGPA, still actually I found the course very interesting and it was futuristic also. But after some third year of final year, you get the reality check, right? I found out that there is no such career in India, at least in India.
Absolutely.
There is no proper biotechnology career. So I was like, at one point, I liked the course very much. But the only option for me was to go into research. and I don't have much patience to go into research and PhD and all that. So
and
it was very close.
Unfortunately, yeah. India though does not even value research and PhD that much. I mean, you still have a lot of more opportunities abroad if you look at in research per se. But that's absolutely true and correct. So then, what was your entire, like from VIT, where you're studying something which is so different, biotechnology, coming to Indore? Like, how was the transition? How was the new life at IIM Indore first year? You've gone through one complete year.
Yeah, once I stepped into IIM Indore campus, initially I was very awestruck with the campus and the people there. Because as I said, I didn't have any idea how an IIM will be and how the people will be, how the entry will be and everything. So once I went there, initially I was very intimidated. Afterwards, I found that everyone by coming from similar backgrounds. Like even though they some had work experience, some had engineering, arts, commerce, and everything, everybody had their own story. Not everyone had the complete success story from their childhood to IIM. Everyone had their ups and downs, and everyone had their different experiences. So that's what inspired me the most. After that, I got it was like pretty normal. Initially, you get that. Intimidating feeling, but after some time you go on with it. You get used to it.
So what was the intimidating fact? Like the peers around you or the whole curriculum and the transition of management? What was the most intimidating fact for you?
Yeah, actually initially everything was intimidating because you know that how hectic the first term of IIM will be. First 3 months was like you have a club recruitment, placement, summer placement. And academic also will be a bit heavy and it will be a new place also. You don't get time to settle down. So you will be juggling everything at once. And also the peers are actually everyone comes from different places and they are top talents of the country. So you have so much to learn. And you also feel a bit underwhelming because everyone would have come from a good place with good grades and good work experience. So after coming here, everyone feels normal. Because even the people who have been toppers all their childhood, they feel normal after coming here. So
because everybody out there is a topper there.
Yeah, true. That was intimidating.
Very nice. So I think you guys have a really huge campus, you know, with the amazing grounds and everything. So how was, what's your favorite area or spot of the campus that, you know, you miss right now, if you were to say?
There is not one spot actually because our campus, as you said, it's one of the biggest campus of IIM and also it's located on a hilltop, so it's a mini paradise. We call it a castle on the hill because it really is a castle because you have to spend 1 hour to come from Indore to our campus and you can see our campus from 1 kilometer actually because it will be distinct. You can see a separate hill and on that the campus will be there. It will be so majestic. Yeah. And also, you know that in the undergraduation, most of the colleges, you have so many strict rules and all.
Yes.
And you won't have that much freedom. So after you come to IIM, you have all the freedom in the world and all the party lifestyle. And you like no one asks you anything. You are on your own. So that feeling was very different. All the late night walk and all the friends and all the parties.
Oh, interesting. So all campus late night exploring and everything, right? Like which you got... Amazing. So that's, you know, what actually the real life of an IIM guy is like, you know, if you say the whole day of yours, you had to pick up one day, which is like the most normal day for you. What is the day like?
Usually in term one, I can pick up because that is the most hectic and most difficult for term a person can face. So in that, the usual day will be early morning, 9 o'clock, you will usually have a class. And you have to give biometric. There is a biometric attendance system.
Oh, okay.
And our hostel is located down the hill, and the academic block is up on the hill. So you have to literally climb 1,000 steps to go to the academic block. And you feel so exhausted after climbing all the steps, and still you have to run to give the biometric. So exactly at 9 o'clock, when the feeling when you give the biometric will be so exhilarating. Yeah.
You guys are all fit, no? You all don't need to have any workout sessions, 1,000 steps you're climbing on a daily basis.
Yeah, our fitness really got ruined after coming to lockdown actually because there we used to walk at least 3-4 kilometers every day.
Wow.
Here we are sitting in Zoom all days.
Okay, so 9 o'clock is like a biometric. You start your day with the lectures and all. So how does the rest of the day go like? Till when do you have your lectures and all?
Usually till 1 o'clock, 1 o'clock is the lunch break. Till one, we usually have three lectures.
Okay.
And some days we have after one also, after the lunch break, 2:30, we'll have one or two more lectures. But mostly it will be three lectures only, three lectures a day.
Okay.
In the afternoon period, you will have time on your time for your own. You can take a nap or you can play games or anything with your friends. And in the evening time, you will get some calls from the placement committee or for some PPT, or you will have some quiz on the next day. So you will have to prepare on that. And the late night is the best part actually. After 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock, you won't have much things to do because everyone would have finished studying and everyone would have done their individual hobbies. So the late night mostly it will be gathering in someone's room and having fun. Just talking, gossip or anything and having fun. Or it will be going all around the campus for a late night walk. We'll walk till 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock and then call it a day.
Wow, that's amazing. Like, you know, spending so much time with friends. I think you would have built really strong bonds on campus in 1 year, you know, with so many students, friends and batchmates out there.
Yeah, we definitely did because it was my first hostel experience. In VIT, I was not a hosteler. I stayed outside. So it was my first hostel experience, and it's in a different state, which is far from my hometown.
Yeah.
So even though initially it was intimidating, after that, those friends became my family, actually.
Very true, very true. That's really nice. That's the most amazing part, I think, you know, when you get to meet so many people, you're spending so many hours together. You know, that's more than like family out there. Very good. So like you also mentioned, Krishna, that, you know, the first term is the most hectic. You have so many things to do. You have placements, you have committees and all of them. So at any point of time, did you ever feel that, you know, I think I'm not meant for this. I want to give up. And, you know, like, did that feeling ever sunk into you sometime?
I think everyone who goes for IIM feels that somewhere in the first term, because that is designed to make you feel that way. The objective of the first term is, even some faculty used to say, is to prepare us for the corporate world, because in corporate world it won't be all roses, so you have to face some cons also. So
it's a roller coaster ride completely.
Yeah, you have to juggle so many things, but at the same time, if you have good time management skills. Actually, it's not as hectic as people portray it to be. If you have good time management skills and if you have your own preferences. For example, some people might want good placement. Some people might want to get a gold medal. So everyone's preference is different. So it's more about you, what you prefer than trying in your hand in everything.
True, that makes sense. You know, like prioritizing, do you want to have a good exposure or you want to have a good sports and entertainment life and all of them? Very true. That's really nice and kind of time management. So what would you suggest for people who are, you know, about to join, like the next batch is right about to start with their journey. So what would you recommend that, you know, before you go ahead, what should you be prepared for? And, you know, like three things which you should keep in mind before you start your IIM journey right now.
Before IIM journey, first thing I will suggest is, as I said, to have your own goal. Because IIM is the best place because it gives you a cushion, comfort cushion. Because not in every places you get a good placement for everyone and good exposure and good alumni network. So the main motto of getting to IIM is because you have something to fall back upon. So it makes no sense to try to focus on everything and lose your sleep over it. Because at the end of the day, after 2 years, anyways, you will perform really well and you will get a reasonably good job. No matter what you do in those 2 years. Because you already ended up there in IIM. You had something in you that made you end up there. So I would suggest not to stress too much when going to IIM to have a clear goal. If you want to be a gold medalist or if you want to focus on extracurriculars or if you want a really good placement and want to concentrate on the profile, first choose what you want and also try to focus on the skill set, not on certificates and the recognition. For example, digital marketing or you can say, similar examples, there are so many certificates, so many theory. But at the end of the day, during placement or during an interview with someone, what matters is what you did in that. For example, in digital marketing, the best way you can learn is by creating a website and selling it, try to sell a product on your board. Nothing can teach you that. No certification can teach you that. So try
that
to
should
focus
be practical on learning along with, you know, whatever you are. Don't just collect certificates, but actually execute them and learn.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So there's also one other thing is, you know, when you go from engineering, it's more of a theoretical approach. And when we come to an MBA, it's all about, you know, case studies and all of them. So how many case studies do you think you would have done in your first year?
I think it will be around 100 for sure.
Wow. Okay. So this different.
Underestimate actually. 100 will be underestimate. It will be more than that, I guess.
More than that, I'm sure, because yeah. Every subject, everything is all about case studies, right? So what was the yeah. most, which you know, like if you have to remember, like the best case study that you studied in your first year, which is it that you remember the most?
I will say the first case study in marketing. That was a case I remember the most. I forgot the name of the case, okay. But it will be about a cigarette company like which produces herbal cigarettes. I think yeah. you would have heard it also. So in that case study, we will initially they will ask how to improve the business and all those stuff, and we will give so many suggestions in the first two classes. And at the end of the day, they will ask us to think for once whether the business plan was even viable and whether they even had any customer base. And any they provide any value to the customers. So that started so many things, because blindly after seeing the case, we gave so many innovative suggestions and all the business plans and all those executive strategy and all. But at the end of the day, we didn't think anything about the customers or the value they provided. So that line which they said, it's still on our mind.
So it's the kind of learning approach is different. You know, like people always have a habit of jumping to solutions and not actually yeah. thinking behind the reasons and all of that. That's actually one of the most amazing things. I mean, I'm also an MBA in marketing, and I loved those thought process behind, you know, those case studies which are there. Interesting. So along with all of these things, so what all committees were you a part of in college?
I was not part of any committee, but I was okay. part of three phases.
Okay.
There was one is marathon phase in which I was called Udan, in which I was in yeah. part of media and the PR committee. And okay. for our cultural phase, Iris, I was in corporate relation committee and I was responsible for getting sponsorship.
Okay.
And also for another phase called Udan, Iris, and I just forgot actually, I'm in lockdown. Okay. And I was also in a dramatics club actually.
Interesting.
Yeah, it was also a very interesting experience.
So then you get time to do all of these things. I mean, like sponsorship is very taxing, and it's like one of the most challenging things which you are up to in college. So you manage to balance with your academics and this?
Yeah, the problem I had is before I came to IIM, I didn't have much extracurricular in my resume. I okay. didn't explore much mm-hmm. in my undergraduate. So I was actually in a bit of pressure to do those things, because you know that during the placements or during the overall perspective, it does affect if you don't have much
yes.
extracurricular.
Yes.
So initially, I attended everything and tried to get in everything because of that. But after I got in, it was a really different experience actually. After that I got in, I never felt stressed out or I felt like obligated to do anything. I naturally felt the interest to do all those things. As you said, sponsorship is a very tough business actually. Mm-hmm. But still, here also the IIM tag actually helps. At least the people listen to you when you pitch about something in IIM. So it also helped, and it was actually a great learning experience, how to do a cold call and pitch a sponsorship deal and get it done with.
Correct. So that's absolutely true in terms of, you know, like actually, so that's a point I think I would suggest all the other people who are watching us also today having this discussion, like Krishna mentioned this, extracurriculars play an important role too when it comes to your placements. You know, it talks about your exposure and everything. So guys who are still in their graduation colleges, engineering, BMS, BCom, take this opportunity, go and get some exposure, do some, you know, PR, marketing. It might feel like, you know, it's not one of the great things which I was looking forward to, but you will learn, and that adds value to the whole resume is what, you know, you are here saying. So that's actually a very nice thing, Krishna. I think all those people should make note of this, you know. Guys, all of y'all who are watching the videos, I hope y'all are making notes and, you know, taking learning from their experiences, because these are people who've been there, done that, have gone through the same journey as you have gone, and, you know, obviously would have made it up there. So, right? So, they're the ones who've cracked it up. So, follow their secrets. And very conveniently, he said, you know, it's a little challenging, but we can learn to balance time. But I know it's genuinely very taxing. You are doing a part of dramatics, you are being in PR and media sales, you're doing sponsorship. And with all of this, you have to take care of your academics, your grades, your placements. Amazing. So that's surely amazing, Krishna. Lovely to hear that entire experience of yours, right from, you know, not planning to make an IIMs to come down here.